Hello everyone, my name is Maran Magomi, and today I'll be showing you a quick demo of curating datasets for parameter-efficient fine-tuning with synthetic data generation. This is an overview of a tutorial that we recently published on NeMo Curator's GitHub repository. The goal of this tutorial is to curate a high-quality dataset consisting of legal question answers suitable for fine-tuning a large language model. To this end, we use the Law Stack Exchange dataset, which is publicly available on Hugging Face. Every record contains a question title, a question body, along with human-provided answers to that question. As part of this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the NeMo Curator framework to further augment the size of your dataset by producing synthetic data from the NemoTron 340B instruct model. I additionally demonstrate the usage of the NemoTron 340B reward model to assign qualitative scores to the synthetic data. Lastly, I'll show you how to use the NeMo Curator framework to perform semantic deduplication on your data to discard all records that are semantically similar. Let's get started. Although this notebook can be executed on your local machine, in order to experience all the functionality, you will need access to an NVIDIA GPU along with an API key for build.nvidia.com in order to issue calls to the NemoTron models. Let's dive into the code. The very first step of this data curation pipeline is to download and convert the dataset from Hugging Face to a format that is understandable by the NeMo Curator framework. This is done by the implementation of the document builder modules that are provided by the NeMo Curator. After that, we are ready to run our data curation pipeline. This function captures the main processing pipeline of this tutorial. We process the data in two stages, data filtering and cleaning, the first stage, and synthetic data generation, the second stage. We perform this iterative process as many times as necessary to achieve the desired dataset size. Now let's take a closer look at the dataset filtering and cleaning stage. We define a set of curation steps that are applied sequentially to our dataset. Specifically, we are interested in cleaning up all the HTML tags from our data, making sure that all the Unicode characters are uniform, and also apply some basic filters on our data to make sure that all the question and answer pairs are within a specific length. Note that all of these processing can be done on the CPU and do not require a GPU. Next, we define the processing stages that require the GPU. Specifically in this case, we perform semantic deduplication on our dataset, which ensures that all of our records are semantically unique. Once these operations are done, we are ready to perform the next stage of our pipeline, which is synthetic data generation. These operations are implemented inside this file, where there are two prompt templates that allow us to interface with the synthetic data generation model and obtain the synthetic records. The first prompt instructs the model to generate questions from a posted human answer. The second prompt asks the model to paraphrase an existing question or an existing answer. We can additionally ask the model to produce n different variants to improve diversity. After producing synthetic records, we can prompt the reward model and assign a helpfulness score to every record. This allows us to filter low-quality records using the NeMo Curator. After we've produced enough synthetic records, it is time to rerun our curation pipeline again. This ensures that a combination of the real as well as the synthetic data do not contain semantically similar records, and also ensures that all the records are within a specific length. Once this pipeline has executed for a desired number of rounds, we are ready to write out the final results. Now let's run this pipeline on our machine and see the results. This will take some time. Let's inspect the output and understand what happened. The code started with a dataset of roughly 19,000 records. After the first round of curation, it ended up with a dataset of size 12,000 records. This indicates that the dataset may have contained a lot of semantically similar records, and also records that were not within the specified lengths. The code then proceeded to generate 12 synthetic records. After that was done, we reran the curation pipeline and ended up with a dataset that was just over 12,000 records, slightly larger than what we started with. This concludes my demo. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it.